Okay, so maybe we'll start with you, Superintendent Small. Let's talk a little bit about your relationship with the public safety partner agencies, whether that's police or fire department or EMS, anything else, about your relationship there and why you think that's important to you as an administrator of a large school district here in the Valley.
First of all, thank you for the opportunity to talk today and have a conversation. I think that one of the things that I'm a firm believer of is that the relationship we have with our fire department, our police departments, our cities, but in this case, our fire department is just so important to us for the safety of our students, for the safety of our community. And, you know, sometimes people think that as public agencies, we may not have the same mission. And that's probably true. There are different parts of our mission, but in a fire department, there's education parts of your mission. There's safety parts of our mission that are important too. And what I have always enjoyed about the Spokane Valley Fire Department is there is a willingness to sit and talk through those areas where our missions interconnect. And the thing that I would say is that being able to discuss those issues where our missions interconnect happens because there's a relationship between individuals or the organizations themselves. And then after you get that relationship built, if you're willing to sit and listen to one another and one another's needs, then you can start breaking down barriers that might be in place for programs to take place in the betterment of our community. And I think that's what we have here, whether it's the Liberty Lake Police Department, Spokane Valley Police Department, whether it's Liberty Lake Council or our county commissioners or our city of Spokane Valley Council. So critical in order for some of those programs that really support both of our missions can be implemented.
Bryan, from your perspective, you got a unique perspective, obviously, being a former police chief for decades and now in a public safety role, primarily, my understanding is, with the school district in charge of, you know, our safety of our most precious resources, really, our children. What's your take on that view and that collaborative relationship and the interconnectivity that superintendent's talking about?
Yeah, thanks, Chief Collins. I appreciate this opportunity. And really to echo what Superintendent Small has said, to be successful in anything that we do requires that partnership and collaboration. From my perspective, you know, the goal is to create a safe and civil learning environment for staff and students at Central Valley School District. And as you alluded to earlier, we can't do that alone. We can't do that in a bubble. And so we really count on our community partners to make that happen. And again, that is the multiple jurisdictions that we're serving. It involves public safety agencies. So not only Spokane Valley Fire, but Spokane Valley Police, the Sheriff's Office, Liberty Lake Police. And we work with all of our public safety agencies on a daily basis to ensure the safety of our students and staff at Central Valley. From a boots on the ground perspective, you know, when we look at the Spokane Valley's rapid response teams working with our law enforcement partners in our schools in the event we were to have a active situation, and we train and we drill and we work together, and without those relationships and partnerships preparing for the safety of our students, then we would not be as successful as we have been.
That's a great point. Let me kind of come at it from a different angle. And that is how the schools are contributing, in my perspective, to the overall betterment of public safety in our community. And I'll give you a couple examples as the fire chief that are striking to me. The programs we have around CPR in the schools and Stop the Bleed in the schools, and those types of programs that we work with the school district to train kids, to teach kids, to give them the tools to live in our community and then use those tools to make it a safer place to live. What are you guys' thoughts on that view? I mean, I look at it and go, oh my gosh, you know, I've been working on, you know, cardiac arrest survival rates now for the better part of my career, which is too many decades to mention. But I one of the biggest advances that I saw in that was when Washington said, we're going to train all those high school seniors to do CPR, the most fundamental, probably best life-saving thing that we could equip anybody in our society with. So I'd just like to get your thoughts on that and how much, in my view, that just makes our community so much safer.
From my perspective, one of the things that true learning doesn't stay within the school walls. That senior who has this training is going to come across somebody who needs their help. And that person is probably going to be outside the school. It could be a family member in a drowning situation. It could be training in how to get out of a house fire. All of those things that come in to play, and even in our youngest of learners, learning how to dial 911 appropriately and how to be appropriate on a 911 call, I think all of those things don't stay centered in a school. They are integrated out into the community. And I think that makes our community safer. And I think without those partnerships, learning has a tendency to stay in the school and not be applied outside. So every time we're teaching a student first aid and we're working with the Valley Fire Department to do that, they're learning how to apply that, not in a classroom setting, but in a real world setting.
Yeah. Excellent. Great, great point. Bryan, your thoughts on those programs and how it makes the community safer?
Yeah, well, thank you. So obviously our first priority and our first goal is prevention, right? We want to make sure that we do everything that we have, use the resources we have available to us to prevent tragedies and bad things from happening. But as we know, bad things do happen. And in the event those bad things happen, you know, the more prepared we are to handle those things, then the better the outcome. And so specifically, I'd just like to address the Stop the Bleed program campaign. And so several of our schools have already received that training, which is really, it's a life-saving measure. And the more people that we have trained in that Stop the Bleed campaign, the better. And as Superintendent Small said, maybe not even in the school, but it could be something that they're coming across in their everyday activity outside the school. That training still applies and could potentially save a life. So one of the things I have actually on my work plan is to expand the Stop the Bleed campaign to all of our schools in the district to provide that training and look at funding to try to get the equipment that's necessary to make that happen, from the compression bandages to the tourniquets that are needed that we could deploy throughout the school that we hope we would never need from a prevention standpoint, but know that we're prepared and ready to save a life in the event we need to do so.
You know, one thing that I would add, Chief Collins, is that it is the quality of the fire department personnel that truly makes a difference in these trainings. It is the quality of the presentation, the professionals that interact with our students from Spokane Valley Fire Department, the professionals that we see respond to emergencies in our schools when there is an emergency. That makes a total difference. So when we look at this, we see the quality of Spokane Valley Fire Department. And because of that quality, we know and understand that we're going to get these quality interactions and the quality partnerships. And so I just want to point that out, that when we know we're going to interface with a Spokane Valley Fire Department personnel, it's going to be a quality interaction, and that can't be understated.
Right. So you don't have enough time in your day to be doing things that don't yield good quality results. Obviously, in the schools, your time is limited. So we appreciate that, and we want to make sure that, you know, when we're interacting with you guys, that we're giving you everything we can in the most professional and, you know, efficient, effective manner. To help you guys be successful, help the kids be successful. Let's talk a little bit. I got a couple more just quick things I want to cover. One being, let's talk about this little road project that we've been working on. Now, Bryan, you've been working on it in a different capacity, but I'm sure you're still working on it to some degree. People ask me as a fire chief, you know, what is kind of weird. Some of the firefighters are like, I don't understand. How come what's going on with the roads, and why are we doing something with the city and the school? What's the schools got to do with the roads? And so I explained to them a little bit about the partnership again, how that works and how we support each other, that are things in areas that are maybe not necessarily, in this case, they are directly related to our success, but even if they weren't, if they're related to your success, how we support each other in those endeavors. But in this case, when we talk about roads, I look at it from the fire chief and Bryan from the police chief's perspective. You know, it's about access. It's about response times. It's about circulation, keeping our traffic moving so that we don't jam up streets. So then that impedes our ability to get to emergencies and so on and so forth. But Ben, I know you've been in this from the very beginning with us, and just like your perspective on that kind of unique collaboration, that effort was unique, I think, in our area, and probably why it was successful in Olympia.
Yeah, I think there are very few times when a city, a fire department, and a school district would go to Olympia to advocate for a specific transportation project. But when you do that, what happens is, you get noticed, right? When you get noticed, when somebody is saying, well, why is a fire department and a school district advocating for an overpass? And then you start to understand the stories of why we are. And this is why we are. We have a brand new middle school located on the north side of the freeway. We have emergency services on the south side of the freeway. And it is in our best interest to move those emergency services across that freeway to our school in case of one of those unfortunate situations where we're in a crisis. And when you're in a crisis, a minute is a long time. And that road will shave off minutes to that response. So it creates that piece. And then in a greater piece, we have a brand new high school going up on Country Vista, and our students will be interacting with traffic. High school students, my son is learning to drive right now and will be driving a 16-year-old driver in the summer. And I think about his interaction in and around our schools, and especially our high schools. And that overpass and that traffic project the transportation project that we advocated for as a team will create a safer environment around Ridgeline High School. And at the same time, we also see then traffic being facilitated for commerce. And you might say, well, why is the school district concerned about commerce? Well, we want a vibrant economy. We want an economy that attracts community members who want to live in this and contribute in this community. And so from a lot of different perspectives, when you can look outside what may be on the surface your main goal or main mission, we can then come together, find that commonality, and make a big impact for this community. When our police department can talk about traffic safety and accidents and how we can avoid those, it goes back to what Bryan was saying earlier, Mr. Asmus was saying earlier about we try to prevent. And this is a prevention piece.
Well said. Bryan, your thoughts on that?
Yeah, well, I echo those thoughts. And again, you know, you have to look at the bigger picture, right? I mean, we cannot do this, you know, in isolation. We can't look at just, you know, what is best for Central Valley School District. We have to work with our community partners and do what's best from a safety perspective. And I think that the transportation project is an excellent example of that collaboration and working together to accomplish something that's going to benefit not only from a public safety standpoint, a learning school district standpoint, transportation standpoint, and commerce standpoint. So it's a win-win for everybody. And it's just amazing that we're able to work together and collaboratively to make that big project happen.
yeah, that was a great project. Proud to be part of it with you guys, and hoping it continues to be successful so that we can all see the benefits of that play out. And the last thing I'd like to talk about is a program that I'm really, you know, always been excited about. Like to see if we can work to even improve it more for whatever help we can. And that is the great program you guys run at Spokane Valley Tech. When that school opened, I was invited to the opening, and I thought, oh my gosh, why isn't everybody doing this? And, you know, maybe I'm missing something outside of, you know, our area. I just hadn't heard of much of that type of thing going on. But what an avenue to, you know, apply to all those kids in school, in high school, that really might not follow the traditional, you know, path to college, what has become the traditional path, you know, into college, higher education, all that other things, but really to give them some skills in a different way to contribute, you know, be a great contributor to our community and society. So I thought, wow, that was amazing. And then the FIRE program, you know, we recently in our most recent recruit class of 14 hired, you know, one of our youngest recruits ever, Isaac Matt, who is a product of that, of your school district, and is now, you know, a contributing member of the fire department, making our community safer. Yeah. And talk a little bit about that program, if you would, and the partnership there. I just think it's a win-win. That's a great partnership in my view.
Well, first of all, I would say that those type of partnerships build off of first a discussion, and then the ability that, you know, you start talking about that, and then you talk about how do we get our students engaged, and how do we set the pathway for somebody who wants to be a firefighter, somebody who wants to be an EMT, somebody who wants to serve their community as a first responder. Because you can teach those skills in isolation. The thing that is so important about the fire science program at Spokane Valley Tech is it's taught by firefighters. It is taught by the professionals, and they can guide and help our students not only learn the skills, but understand the pathway to get to the point where you've just hired one of those recruits. And so it's a prime example of where the pathway is connected to the learning. You know, sometimes a student will go in and learn math and do really well at it. But then they come back and go, okay, how does this connect to my pathway and where I'm going? The fire science program connects all of that. So they're learning all of these critical skills of what it is to be a firefighter. And then they really have mentors that are helping them understand the pathway where they need to go. And then there's side benefits of this. Many of our students who go through that program will fight wildfires in the summertime. And they're making then money, good money. It's a long, hard work, and it's dangerous work, but they're making money that will help them start their, if they want to go to university, if they want to go to another program, they now have money to launch whatever that pathway is. And so what starts as a connection with our firefighters turns into mentorships, turns into understanding the pathway and how to get there and how to navigate it. Because, you know, one of the things that I understand is that it's not very often that becoming a firefighter is a straight line. You do this, then you do this, then you do this. You've got to get into some volunteer service. You get into an EMT, you work your way into the system. And it can be confusing. This alleviates all of that confusing pieces of the pathway to get there. The quality again. We feel very proud of the fact that we know that our students are interacting with quality Spokane Valley Fire Department personnel that are compassionate, that understand and are professional in the job. And we can't be more proud of it. We're really proud of where we think we may go into the future and building on it and expanding it.
Yeah, I echo that. Bryan, your thoughts on that that program from your perspective?
Well, for sure, it is a unique and successful program. And to have that mentorship, to have instructors that have that real world world experience to relay that type of learning to our students is absolutely amazing and gets them engaged and excited about a potential career path. And I'd just like to say also, in addition to what's happening formally at Spokane Valley Tech, you know, we do have professional peace officers in all of our high schools. So we have two deputies from the sheriff's office and then an officer from the Lake Police Department that are there to be a resource for the students and staff. But I think more importantly, are there to provide that mentorship and to provide that guidance. And I've already experienced this year of students coming up to those police officers and sheriff's deputies and asking them questions about their career field and, you know, how did they get involved in law enforcement? And so from, you know, not only the Spokane Valley Tech, the formal process that's happening, we have that mentorship happening as well from a law enforcement perspective in our high schools. And I think that's just so valuable to our students to have that experience.
Right. I agree 100%. To both you guys, I that program, it really is amazing and it has a tremendous amount of potential. And I fully believe that, you know, we're likely to see, in the future, a member come through that program, whether it's this young person we just hired or somebody in the future that will have the opportunity to be sitting in my chair as the fire chief of this organization in the future. Protecting our whole community, which is just amazing to think about.
Well, Chief Collins, I would say this is that through that mentorship, leadership is built. Leadership skills are built through that program, and then the application of that leadership. And when I say leadership, sometimes you're a team member and somebody who's following, and other times you may be the one who's commander on site. And our kids learn that in high school, and you can't replace that. Right. You know, the other thing that I would say, if I could, you talk about the partnership we have with the fire department at Spokane Valley Tech, the partnerships we have in working with informally, getting our firefighters in, talking to our elementary kids to understand fire safety. You talk about then looking at the partnership we formed on this transportation project. And when we in the Central Valley School District were faced with a very short turnaround time in order to get our N95 masks fitted for our teachers as we returned to in-person learning, the first people we turned to and asked if there was a resource was the Spokane Valley Fire Department. And I am amazed at the willingness to work together to make that happen. And I believe the fire department was motivated and saw this as a service to our community and a service to our youth and a service to our teachers to protect them as well. And I can't be more proud of that. I can't be more proud of the fact that we, because of the relationship and the partnership that we have established, it was set up in a very short order. And I think it was a tremendous service, and we're forever grateful.
Well, we appreciate that, Ben. And I would say, we didn't even have to ask our people to do that. They all we had to do was start to ask them, and they were like, we take care of it. Not a problem. And that's because we have great people who care about the community. That's a big that's not universal, you know, out there in the world. But it is universal in this area. Our folks care about what they do. They care about the community outside the fire department. That's what we're here for. And I couldn't be prouder of our folks just stepping up, willing to do whatever we would ask them to do. But more importantly, we don't even have to ask. They're just ready to go, which says a lot about the character of the people we have.
Exactly.
Yeah. So appreciate that. Well, I think that wraps up everything I wanted to cover today.
I think we've got it. I could talk for hours. So as you probably noticed.